Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video from the safe, Beretta PX4 Storm Special Duty, chambered in 45 ACP. So I'm basically running out of things to show you guys. We're getting to that point again. And I figure I grabbed this one out of the safe because it is kind of a unique handgun. And I haven't done a video about this. So let's just dive into this. And again, this is a barbershop gun talk channel. I do not review guns. We're here just to hang out, talk shop, and look at some different things. That's all this is, okay? So this one here, it comes in a very nice, cool looking, almost like a Pelican case. I think that's a nice touch. I bought this because I wanted something in the stable that had a little bit of history, meaning, well, first let's open this case up and then we can talk. But as you can see, it says Special Duty on that badge right there, which is kind of cool. But here it is. In this nice case, it kind of reminds me what a Colt tried to do years ago with their M45A1. It came in their Pelican case and all that cool stuff. But the M45A1, it's an okay 1911, but it's nothing that special, like a Wilson Combat or Nighthawk Custom. But here it is. So this is called, like I said, PX4 Storm Special Duty, chambered in 45 ACP. Comes in this really cool case. Now, like I said, I got this because of its kind of history. If we go back to the year 2005, the U.S. was a military joint combat pistol program, which was back in 05, so long ago. I guess the premise of that program was to replace the M9 that was being used back then. And they stipulated it had to be in 45 ACP, okay, as well as being capable of mounting a suppressor. That's interesting. Sound suppressor. And then being able to fire 5,000 rounds without failure. And I think some of the pistols were, what was it, the SIG P220, the FN P45, which I have one of those, and of course the HK45, which I have one of those as well. And this one here was entered into the program, and nothing happened. nothing happened with that. So I thought that's interesting that they had this program and just nothing ever happened. But that's why I wanted to get this one, to kind of complete, I don't want to say a collection of some sort, but I like the history of this handgun because it's kind of like unknown. Nobody knows about the PX4 Storm Special Duty, nor does anybody care about this handgun at all. That is abundantly clear because anytime I have brought this handgun out to the range to shoot it, nobody bats an eye at this thing. Nobody cares about this handgun. It's Mr. Potato Head's gun. They think it's ugly. They think it's stupid. They're like, what is that thing? What the heck? They don't understand it, and they're like, I don't care about it. So, me personally, I do like this gun a lot, just for the sake of its history. Back in, like I said, back in 2005, what they were trying to do with this thing. And it's a cool gun to shoot. So, let's just kind of take a closer look at this case that it came with. I mean, it's kind of neat. See, it says PX4 Storm. Little right up here, manual comes in here. Manual, some of the, you know, rust proof paper, if you will call it, wax paper, whatever it is. Three magazines. What are they, 10 round mags, flush fit, but these are extended ones actually, with an extended. So, oh, 9 rounds, and these are 10 rounds. Yeah, 10 round mag. And I don't shoot this gun much at all. So that's on the first layer. What do you got in here? You got some gun oil, a magazine loader. Okay, this is the, oh, this is for the plug right here. Sorry, took me a little bit because there's a lanyard loop right here. See on the bottom of the gun? I believe this just plugs it up if you don't want the lanyard loop. You got that, and then you had different size magazine release that you can swap out, larger to smaller, and some back straps in here that you can put on, adjust the back strap. This must be, oh, that's just a cleaning kit. What is this? Warning from the Massachusetts, oh boy, poor Massachusetts gun owners. Anyways, okay, so that's the case. Looks pretty cool, looks pretty nice. We'll just put this to the side. We'll just take a look at the gun right here. And I love the color scheme of this handgun. It's got the polymer frame that's flat dark earth or coyote brown, whatever you want to call it. And it has this extended barrel. okay, that's not threaded. So I've seen that, I guess you could put a sound suppressor on here with this weird contraption on the rail. It's very bizarre, I don't get it, but it's not threaded, so I'm not sure what that was about. Unfortunately, this is a decock safety system. Okay, we'll take out the mag. So, you know, it's double action, first shot, single action, subsequent, and when you want to decock the firearm, you grab one of these bat wings up here and you push it down, and it stays down, decocks the hammer, and now it's on safe. Nothing can work. For a carry gun or for a duty weapon, that is kind of, I don't want to say it's a no-no, but I really don't like that option at all. It should bounce back up so it's not on safe anymore. So it's red, you're dead. So it does have the famous rotating barrel. See that? Like the PX4 compact that I have, the 9mm. However, for the 45, I honestly do not feel any type of recoil reduction feeling or anything. I kind of feel like it kind of pops to the side a little bit, but it is the, see that rotating barrel? See how that rotates? So that is a cool feature. It's different. It's got a rotating barrel, but it's, I don't believe for the 45 ACP, I mean, look at that freaking gaping hole. it doesn't seem to reduce recoil, felt recoil at all. So I don't know. But again, regardless, I like this handgun because it's just different. It has these sand-resistant magazines like that. It's got that coating on there. Yes, this has an extended base plate, and I think, yeah, 10 rounds can go into this. Ooh. And like I said, the lanyard loop there, and you can take that, you can remove that for that little piece in the case if you want it flush. It comes out. Now, it is difficult to take out the spring here, so I left this one stock. And it has standard old three-dot white sights. These bat wings do hurt if you grab them just the wrong way. So I do not like how they're, you know, how they protrude like that. See that? But again, this is not a carry gun. This is not a firearm that I would use for anything but going out to the range and enjoying myself with this thing, having fun with this gun, just put some rounds down range. That's it. I would never carry something like this. You can if you want, of course, but it's very large, very bulky, and, you know, there are better 45 ACPs out there, like a 1911. All right, or, okay, fine, a Glock, okay? But this is a, you know, or SIG, you know, some type of SIG, but this is pretty big. So the double action trigger is actually not bad at all. It's very smooth, and it just rolls right back. So the double action trigger on this thing is actually pretty nice, and then it goes to single action, and that's pretty nice as well. So I do like the trigger system on here for being stock. It's pretty good. And that extended barrel just kind of reminds me of a 92, you know what I mean? It does, like I said, it's not threaded, so I don't know what the thinking was, you know, behind that, just having it extend. I don't know if it's supposed to balance the gun better. That's what some people had said. The rotating barrel balances it better. I don't know. You guys got to let me know. Again, I'm not going to go through the specs of this handgun right here, but it is a fun gun to shoot. It is a 45, so, you know, I guess it punches a little bit more. Of course, more than a 9mm, but it's nothing that, you know, big of a deal. So it's got that special duty logo right there that I think is kind of neat, even though it's kind of corny. But the markings right there, pretty nice. All right, you got the Beretta stuff going on. Takedowns right here. I mean, it is, you know, a pretty nice handgun. I wouldn't recommend this handgun just to anybody. I wouldn't go out and buy one of these. I don't know how much these are today. Maybe they're over 1,000 now. That's a bit much for a polymer gun like this. So I wouldn't recommend it unless you are just someone that is like aficionado like myself. And as you can tell, I put the light on here so it could look like this. And yeah, I think that's about it, guys. Well, you can let me know what you think about the Beretta PX4 Storm Special Duty in the comment section below. All right, as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.